We've all got that friend who either sweats loads or hardly ever sweats. It could even be yourself. So a common question I get asked working as an advanced medical practitioner, pharmacist, practicing in family medicine is, why do some of us sweat so much? So in this video, we're going to explore the science behind it. And if you are struggling with excessive sweating, I'm going to give you some really helpful tips to help combat that. So what are we waiting for? Let's begin. So our body has ways of cooling itself down, and sweating is one of those. So when our internal body temperature rises from either stress, exercise, spicy foods, for example, the brain basically signals your sweat glands to produce sweat. And then when evaporation occurs, that's when we get that cooling effect. Now, we do have two main types of sweat glands. So first of all, we have the eccrine glands. These are found all over our body and help regulate our body temperature with very watery sweat. We also have the apocrine glands, and these are mainly in our armpit and our groin region. Now, the main difference is this gland produces a far thicker sweat. And it can also mix with bacteria on the skin, which causes that body odor. So next question is, why do some people sweat more? Some people just naturally sweat more, and here's why. First of all, we've got genetics. Sweating often runs in families. The next possible reason is fitness. Generally speaking, fitter people sweat sooner and more efficiently to cool the body down faster. The third reason is environmental. Hot, humid climates basically keep your sweat glands in overdrive. The fourth reason being medical conditions. Things like diabetes, things like thyroid issues, the menopause, or even infections. These can all increase sweating. And the last reason, medication. Some medication can actually cause us to sweat more as a side effect. So for example, the top three that come to mind, antidepressants like SSRIs, blood pressure medication like beta blockers, and even certain diabetic treatments. So the next question is, what's hyperhidrosis? You may have heard of this medical term. What does it mean? So an easy way to think of it is, if you are sweating way more than is necessary to cool your body, or even at rest, it could be hyperhidrosis. And we have two types: primary hyperhidrosis. This usually affects the hands, feet, armpits, and face. We often see it start in childhood or teenagers. And the second being secondary hyperhidrosis, which is often linked to other health issues or even medication, and often affects large areas of the body. Now, when it comes to hyperhidrosis or excessive sweating, one of the first treatments that's generally recommended is a clinical strength antiperspirant. So for example, here are our SweatBlock antiperspirant wipes. These are the smaller wipes, and these are the extra large antiperspirant wipes. They both contain something known as aluminium chloride. And it's basically really powerful at blocking those sweat glands. And another example just to share, this is the SweatBlock antiperspirant deodorant stick. So this doesn't contain aluminium chloride, but it's got a milder aluminium salt. So it's called aluminium zirconium tetrachlorohydrex. Basically what it means is that one that contains aluminium chloride is far more potent at blocking your sweat glands. So as a result of it, our SweatBlock wipes, you only apply them once a week, whereas our SweatBlock antiperspirant deodorant, you can apply this daily. Now, if, for example, you're sweating a lot from your feet or your hands, we also have the SweatBlock quick dry hand and foot lotion, basically. So these contain aluminium sesquichlorohydrate, which is more gentle on the skin when you compare it to aluminium chloride. But again, they're not as potent, so you can use them daily, you can use them throughout the day, and they dry really quickly. These are great for people who just need a bit of extra help during the day. Now, there's a common myth that aluminium antiperspirants are dangerous, but evidence doesn't back that up at all. Research shows that your skin only absorbs a tiny amount of aluminium, which, by the way, is way less than you get from any food. And major organizations like the FDA, like the American Cancer Society, say that there is no conclusive evidence between aluminium-based antiperspirants and cancer. And here's a quick pro tip for you, by the way. Only products that contain something that blocks your sweat glands, like aluminium salts, for example, can be named an antiperspirant. So when you see deodorants that highlight that they're aluminium free as if it's a great thing, it's not really, because it doesn't have the ability to block sweat. So it's not stopping you from sweating. It's just an air freshener, basically, if you want to think of it like that. It just smells good. So I just thought I'd quickly share that for everyone. Now, whilst we're on the topic of antiperspirants, I just want to give a bit of a pro tip about how often I hear patients using antiperspirants wrong. So I thought I'd just share it in this video as well. You need to always apply an antiperspirant to cool, dry, clean skin. Never. Try not to ever apply an antiperspirant after a hot shower, because your pores are open then and it can cause irritation, and no one wants irritation. So this applies to any antiperspirant you might be using. So whether using our clinical strength antiperspirant wipes or using our clinical antiperspirant and deodorant, any antiperspirant you're applying, this applies to it. basically. Oh, by the way, a common question that we get is, can I use the SweatBlock antiperspirant wipes because you're using it once a week? Can I use the actual SweatBlock clinical strength antiperspirant deodorant as well? Yes, you can. So I just thought I'd let everyone know that as well. Now, because this video is about excessive sweating, we can sweat from all over the body. So far we've given solutions for the armpits, the feet, the hands, the whole body basically, but the face is also a very common one that people have problems with. Now, we do have a targeted solution, our SweatBlock face antiperspirant wipes. They're specially made with ingredients like aluminium chlorohydrate, as well as witch hazel. And this is all gonna help control sweat, reduce shine, and help makeup stay put. And for best results, you should apply this at night to clean, dry skin. Apply it gently, don't press too hard, all around your face. You don't need to rub it, and then let it dry, and then go to sleep. And just a quick tip before using any antiperspirant, I always recommend to do a patch test and always avoid applying it irritated, freshly shaved skin or wet skin. Skin has to be super dry. If you have shaved, wait 24 hours. And remember, these tips apply to any antiperspirant, not just the face wipe. Now, when it comes to sweating excessively, there are times where you should seek medical advice. So I just thought I'd give a few tips now on when you should do that. One, you should seek medical advice if your sweating starts suddenly or changes dramatically. Two, you're sweating excessively at night without any clear reason as to why. Three, sweating is interfering with your daily life, your work, it's just interfering with everything you try to do. And four, if you're ever experiencing any symptoms like chest pain or a rapid heartbeat, please seek emergency medical advice. Or if you're experiencing any unexplained weight loss along with the excessive sweating, again, seek medical advice. Any of these, please seek medical advice. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope that you found this information helpful. Please do share it with your friends. Don't forget to leave us a like and a comment. It really helps the video. We spend a lot of time and effort creating evidence-based, science-backed information for you guys. SweatBlock is a real game changer for excessive sweating. As a US-based company, we offer FDA-approved solutions for excessive sweating. SweatBlock is a number one clinical strength antiperspirant sold online, helping hundreds and thousands of people regain confidence. And do visit our website or Amazon. I'm going to leave links in the description below to learn more about our full product range. And as we always say, SweatBlock, sweat less, live more.